Everybody, and welcome to my actual first life coaching video. So I want to start out today by explaining where my influence comes from wanting to be a life coach, because I am not certified. I'm working towards my certification. So I started following Mastin Kit, founder of thedailylove.com, when I was probably like 16 or 17. And I've, you know, watched him build from the bottom. Just he's so influential with his following, and it really has inspired me. I also worked for this woman named Sylvia. I did like little personal assisting stuff, but she was a life coach, and she would give me life coaching sessions in exchange for some of the work that I did sometimes, and it was really amazing. She's so awesome. She really believes in love and like really practices love. She will send love to people who normally you would want to cuss out. She is so stellar. And I've also, you know, followed now more and more life coaches and been more and more influenced, and just really feel like this is my calling, that this is my path. I'm hoping to build my own heart-centered business around life coaching and including yoga and hula hooping and eating healthy, because that's so important to keep a good state of mind. Because if you're not eating properly, then your brain is starving. And if your brain is starving, then it's unhappy and you're unhappy. Even if you're eating donuts all day, that's not nutritious, so your brain is still starving. So with that being said, part of my life coaching recommendation is definitely to keep up with your nutrition, keep up with your exercise, and whether it be yoga, hula hooping, running, swimming, anything that gets your heart pumping that you love, that's what you need to be doing. Soccer, sports, I don't care. Get moving. And I also want to include, you know, the meditation aspect and everything like that, because that strengthens the bond with yourself so much that it's really hard to not feel better about yourself when you're exercising and eating healthy and meditating and everything like that. You know, it just develops those bonds so strongly. And so what I want to get into today is a little bit of how we treat other people. With that being said about my friend Sylvia that I worked for and her, you know, being so filled with love for everybody, I want to take a moment to send love to everybody who's watching. And also take a moment to say that you can do everything with love. You can, you know, correct somebody and not make them feel bad about themselves with love. Like, as long as you keep holding on to that, then anything is really possible. And if you keep that in your mind, if you put that at the forefront of hate and anger and frustration and everything like that, then you can really, really move mountains, because people honestly respond to love so much. I mean, the best example that I have is a situation that Sylvia actually went through. She was in a parking lot and a man asked her for money, and she said, "I'm sorry, I don't have any money for you." And he started calling her names, you know, all this stuff. And she told him, which I was so flabbergasted, because I, at this point that I heard this, I was not in a place that I could have done this. She told him, "I'm sending love to you and your family, and I really hope that things turn out okay for you guys." And he came back to her later and he apologized. He said, "I'm sorry, I'm in such a place, and you know, my first instinct was to call you those names, and I really regret it, and I'm really sorry, and I thank you for sending that love to my family, and I really appreciate you." And that was my first moment of realizing that love could actually change so many situations. Because there's, how many times have you been in a parking lot and you've cussed at somebody, or somebody's cussed at you, or, you know, you've been in the car and you're upset? Instead of doing that, Sylvia sends love to those people. She just says, "My love is with you, and I'm going to channel that to you." And I think that is the most beautiful thing ever. And I believe that love can actually change the world, because I've seen it. I've seen it change certain circumstances, and I know that it can change a lot of things. So in summation today, I want you to go through your week and see where you could be more loving, more understanding, and give people that background of love that we all really, really need, that we all really, really want. And if you're watching this video over on YouTube, please hit like and subscribe, and then on over to my website, flowalien.com, and please subscribe to my newsletter there. I will be writing a blog nearly daily, and I also have Mondays. I'll be doing a vlog letting you know what's going on with the week, what I have in store for you, what happened last week, you know, just a general update on me. Tuesdays, I'll be posting hoop tutorials. So this last week I did a hula hoop sizing guide. So if you're interested in starting out, please go check that out. And then tune in next week for our first tutorial. And also, I will be having my Wednesday coaching video along with Yoga Island on Thursdays, which I'm really excited. So that's pretty much my two main, like, really, really exciting fitness things that I have going on. Is I've got the hula hoop improvement movement going on Tuesdays, and then I've got Yoga Island going on Thursdays, and I'll be leading a short little yoga session on YouTube every Thursday for you. So please tune in. Everything's really awesome. It's all designed to help you. And I can't wait to see you. Bye.